So in the virtual classes, we have discussed all the units under training methodology module, unit 1 to 14. And today, one of the important topics in a unit, that is interview skills. So interview skills are very important for an individual to develop. So that we will discuss today, and I'll share this. For our ITI system, all our ITI boys, after successful completion of the course, they will be able to perform their trade related skills. And electronics means they will be able to work as an electronic mechanic, and computer means they will be able to work as a computer operator, and garment field means garment. So in their respective trades, they will be able to perform their skills. So for that, they should get a job. For getting job, they have to develop some skills. So that is our topic. What are the skills required? The interview skills. So after successful, after completion of the session, you will be able to achieve following learning outcome. That is, you will be able to learn and practice interview skills to face the interview confidently. And required skills, what are the required skills? There are so many skills required to face the interview confidently, and to face the members confidently, and interact with the members, and whatever knowledge we have and skill we have, that we have to confidently transfer. So all that you require some important skills, like starting from tailoring your CV, that is your biodata or resume, and preparing for interview. See, before interview, some preparations you require. At interview session, you require something, and after interview also you require some some skills. So that we will see. Then rehearsal is very important before going to the interview. Then listening skills, very very important listening skills. Then body language, and looking good, feeling good, and sound good. So this feel good factors, we'll see what are those: look good, feel good, and sound good. And sometimes telephone interview you may happen to attend. So for that kind of telephone interview, how to attend confidently, and some do's and don'ts in interview. These are the learning outcome for today's session. So let us see what is interview. So interview means interaction between two or more persons for a specific purpose. So there will be some purpose for an interview. There will be some purpose. For that purpose only they are conducting interview, and for that we are applying. It may be for selection of sometimes for course selection also you may have to attend interview, and most of the time you will apply for getting good employment opportunity. For job opportunities, you will apply to scrutinize the better or best candidate or suitable candidates, they will call for an interview. So that is a specific purpose. And meeting of persons face to face. So interview, you will meet persons face to face, especially for the purpose of oral examination of candidates. So you may have written exam also. After written examinations, you will face the interview board. So oral examination will be conducted. So this is the definition of interview. And sometimes you may face, suppose you are going for an interview, you may face one person, single man, one person will conduct interview. He will interact with you and he may assess you for your suitability for that particular post. Sometimes more than one person, three members may be there, two to three members may be there. they will conduct interview, they will interact with you. Sometimes, you know, one group of members will be there, particularly for government organizations, state government or central government organizations. You will have a system, you know, you must have this many members, and one chairman will be there for the interview board, one chairman will be there, and few members will be there. So this, you can see one picture, one person is attending interview and five members are there. Among these five members, one person may be a chairman and few members will be there. So these are the, you know, interview systems, and you know, technical and non-technical also there, that we will, you know, see in detail in the coming slides. So I would like to share, you know, in before going to the interview and at the interview time or after interview, what are the, you know, skills we required and what and all we have to follow that. And before the interview, we should prepare ourselves. So prepare yourself. You are applying for the post. So you have completed your course. After your course, you may have experience or you may not have experience. Doesn't matter. If you have experience, you clearly mention your biodata, how to prepare biodata resume, a simple and a perfect one we will discuss. And you have submitted your application and you have been called for an interview. So interview date is fixed. What you have to do, you have to prepare for that interview, what and all they will ask about the company and about yourself. That is very important. You know, most of the interviews or almost all the interviews, they will ask about yourself. Tell me about yourself, like that. So in that case, we have to tell about ourselves, about our personal background or our skills and knowledge, what and all, our competency, everything we should be able to express properly. For that, we have to prepare ourselves. So prepare yourself, practice your interview skills. So we have to practice. How we can practice? With our friends, we can practice. With our own, you know, ourselves, we practice. Suppose one question they will be asked, this is a general question, that tell me about yourself. That means you can sit alone and speak about yourself. I am so and so. I have completed this course. This is my qualification and this is my experience and this is my strength. Like that, you can say about yourself. So that is practice your interview skills. Learn about the company, nature of work. Then you have applied for a post, you know the company address. It is very important to know about the company also, because a company may produce, you know, it may be a software company or a manufacturing company. What they are manufacturing, how many years, you know, old that company, how many years old, and what is the manufacturer they are manufacturing, and you know, if they are exporting, and what is their turnover and all. If you have the details, you know, that will be an advantage for you. Sometimes they may ask, do you know about our company, what we are manufacturing and all. So in that time, if you tell this is your product and this is your you know, the company strength, and approximately this many members are working in your company, means then they will have interest on you. They will be impressed, you know, on your skills. So that is very important. That is why it is very important to know about the company and nature of your work. So your post may be something. So for the post, you have been called for interview. So you must also know what is your nature of work. So the descriptions might have given in the application time itself, advertisement time itself. So you have to know about the nature of work and check and keep all the required documents. See, these are all before going to the interview. You are preparing all this informations and documents. Check and keep all required documents. See, in interview, they may check your, you know, original documents like your marks card, your certificates, your other documents, whatever required documents and all, they will verify in interview time. So you have to keep everything in a file properly, original documents separately and photocopied documents separately. So this and all you may require, and some stationary items like pen and all you can keep. So these are the required items you should carry for an interview. And find the place. It may be in a local, suppose you are staying in a city and it may be 10 kilometers from your home. So you should think about the company, where is it, how to reach. 10 kilometers means same day you can reach. If it is out of station, so 300 kilometers or 1000 kilometers away from your hometown, means you have to plan your travel. So that and all, plan your journey, that is very important. So we have to find the place, where is it. So if it is far away from your place, then you have to go to the reach the place one day before. If possible, you visit the place the previous day, evening or afternoon, you can go and visit the place. Where is the place? If you are very new to the place, you have not visited that place before, means it is an advantage for you to visit the place, the company, or you know, for example, UPSC, you are going to attend the interview in UPSC, means you can go and see where is that you know, office like. So it is also very important to know the place and plan your journey. So these are the before going to the interview, you are making yourself ready. Then during the interview, so you have reached the place, and you have to reach the place well in advance, maybe 1 hour before. You plan 1 hour before to the interview place, and you have reached the place. And after reaching, you should not you know, get people will have, you know, tension, and they will be tense to what and all they will ask. And sometimes our co-members who are coming for interview also, they may ask us, what's your name, what is your qualification. If you ask their qualification, they may over-qualified from you. So that time you may feel that they are over-qualified than me, what I will do and all. Sometimes somebody will have more experience than you. So this and all we should avoid. We need not to bother about their qualifications, about their experience and all. We are suitable person. You are suitable person. That is why they have called for an interview. So all the suitable people, eligible candidates, will be called for an interview. So you have that confident. You have the feeling that they have chosen me for the interview. That means you are the suitable candidate for the interview. Then in interview, how you face the interview, how you are, you know, transferring your skills or knowledge, and how you are presenting yourself, that is very important. How you are presenting yourself to the interview board members is very important. So feel ease and be confident. You feel confident. Doesn't matter. Some people may be overqualified. Some people may have more experience. Doesn't matter. At that time, half an hour or 45 minutes or 40 minutes or 20 minutes, whatever it may be, the time you are going to spend on interview, that is very, very important time. And that particular time only, they will choose the candidate. So it is not only because of the overqualification or more experience and all. And listen carefully. When you are sitting on the interview room, in the interview room, you have to listen carefully, because you are going to speak more. And they will ask you, if the members are more, 3-4 members, then every member will ask you, interact with you. So you have to speak more. For that, you have to listen carefully what they are asking. You should not ask, pardon, what you are told, because it may irritate people. So it may think that he is not listening, she is not listening like that. So listen carefully. You can also ask questions whenever required, and speak clearly. So listening is very important. You listen carefully what they are asking, and speak clearly. So that is also very important. Use proper body language. Don't slouch. Keep eye contact. So slouching means you are not sitting comfortably, you are not sitting properly. So slouching means your furniture may be different kinds of furniture. You should not occupy like in your sofa. How you sit in your home watching TV and all, you should not be such comfortable. You sit comfortably and sit straight. So don't be slouch means, relaxed manner you should not sit. And proper body language is very important. Eye contact is very important. You look at the members. You have to see all the members. What is their reaction? What they are expecting from you and all? You have to observe. Ask questions when required. Interview board members only will ask you questions. One, they will ask you questions in a relaxed manner. You also should respond to them in a relaxed manner. Some questions you may not know means you tell honestly that I do not know. I don't know. instead of telling some wrong answers or wasting the time explaining so many things which is not required, tell I do not know. That is a very honest answer. So ask questions whenever required. So during the interview, these are the very important skills you require. And after interview, see, detailly we are going to discuss how to prepare for an interview, starting from resume and rehearsal and all. These three things are just we are discussing before you interview and at the interview and after the during the interview and after the interview. So after the interview, interview is over, what you have to do? Thank the members. Thank you. Just say thanks and leave gracefully. Sometimes you may not have satisfied because many questions you might have not answered well. Sometimes you might have got anger. You may feel that my answer is correct, what I am saying is correct, but that member do not know about that, but he's criticizing me like that. It happens in an interview. So they may check your patience, So you should not get, emotionally, you should not lose your emotions. And some people may, get angry and tell, I don't want your job and all. Not a pleasant manners. So we should leave gracefully. Means you might have not satisfied the members, even though you can, smiley face, you can thank them and leave gracefully. That satisfaction should be there. Whatever I have prepared, I have done. If I am not successful, then next time I will learn from these mistakes. I know my strength. I learned my weakness. Next time I will overcome all those weakness and I will do well. So that feel you should have. So leave gracefully. Thank the members. And check your document. So you have come out from the room. You might have submitted your original documents in some sections. You have to go there and collect it. You should not forget to collect your original documents. That is very important. So check your documents, what and all you have carried to the interview, and that you should take it back. If it is a photocopy, no problem. You can hand over to them. Then think about your strength. So how well you have done. You may feel happy that some of the questions you might have done very well. That and all you feel, it will make you happy. So feel happy that you have done very well. At the same time, you might have not done well. Some questions you may not know. So all those things you search. What mistakes I have done. So the next time, you may do well and you can be a successful person. Sometimes, it happens. Everybody might have not done well. So they will choose among the best candidate. If they need to select two candidates or four candidates among 40 or 50 candidates, they will choose the candidates, suitable candidates, not the very best candidates and all. Because interview also, for the purpose to choose four members among 50 members. So if the qualification is none of them is fit, sometimes suitable qualification is not there. None found suitable, like that it happens. But all are suitable, all are having suitable qualifications and required experience and all, means they will choose the candidates among the participants. 50 members means they will choose the most suitable candidates among the 50 candidates. So you may have chance one among them. So don't feel bad and all. Don't think I have not done well, I will not be selected. Don't feel like that. You might have been selected. There may be an opportunity, you will be selected. So feel confident that you may have opportunity, or you might be you might be selected like that. Feel that. And if you find your weakness, you improve all those weaknesses and all. And hope for the best. Always feel confident that I have a good opportunity, I have done it. And if I am not being selected, I will be selected in the next. So hope for the best. That and all your after interview skills. And let us discuss about few more skills. Employer's expectations. So you have applied for a post and they have called for an interview. You must know what is the employer's expectations. They may expect something from you. I told you one person may conduct interview, sometimes two or three members, sometimes a group of people that are all board members, particularly for now IT companies also doing this group of people, but for a long time state and central government interviews and all conducted by group of members. So one chairman will be there and at least four members will be there. So what is their expectations? That you must know. Employer means it may be a company, manufacturing company or IT company or electronics industry. And what is their expectation? Which post you have applied, you have been called for an interview, and what they will expect from you? They will expect something from you, that something is, this fellow is suitable person. This person is a suitable candidate for this particular job. That only their expectations. So they will ask you, tell me about yourself, means you have to speak about yourself. What is your qualification? What is your experience? What is your strength? And all you have to tell. And employer expects fit to their company's skill set. So skill set means there are some group of skills required. Add value, this fellow will add value to our company. And professionalism, if he has been selected for this post, he will have that professionalism. And the communication skills, professionalism is a kind of attitude, how you work in a disciplined manner, how quickly you learn. See, the company working culture and all, you may not know. You may have experience in your subject knowledge you may have, and skill you may have. You may not have the working environment experience about the particular company you may not have worked. So you must have that, working tendency or quickly learning tendency. That is called professionalism. And communication skills is very important. And polite behavior. Everybody will expect polite behavior in the beginning or at the interview time. How well you are expressing yourself, how you are presenting yourself. Confidence is different, but overconfident and rudely answering. Some people will have confident, but overconfident. What I am saying is correct, like that. So that and all we should not have. And teamwork. They will check teamwork, whether this person will be able to work in a team, because company is an organization, or it will follow some system where hundreds or thousands of people are working. So you have to work in a group. Though you may have individual responsibility, sometimes you have to work in a group. So teamwork, whether this person is having the attitude to work in a group or teamwork, that they will check. And decision making is very important. And positive attitude and honesty, these are the skills which will be expected from the interview candidates by the employers. So this you must think, and you have to develop all these required skills. And some of the interview skills, one is communication, very important, because through communication only you are going to present about yourself. You are going to convince them. You are going to sell your knowledge. Selling the product is very important. Marketing is very important, like that. On interview, it may be an half an hour or 20 minutes or 40 minutes. You are going to sell about your knowledge, yourself. You are going to achieve that I am the most suitable candidate for the post. For that, what is required is good communication skill. For a good communication skill, very important thing is listening skill is very important. So be a very good listener and be a very good communicator. You practice is very important, and develop communication skill and body language, eye contact, facial expressions and all. You have to develop. At the same time, you have to see the people, interview board members also sometimes express. If they have interest on you, they will show you through their body language. So if they are coming closer to you, or they are doing some kind of body language like this and all, means they have interest on you and they are very much happy about your knowledge and experience and all. So this and all you must know the body languages of others, and you also should have a good body language and express and mannerisms and all you have to follow. And self-introduction and eye contact also one of the important body languages. So you have to see everyone. suppose 3-4 members means you have to have eye contact with all the members, how they are responding to you and how well you are answering to them, how they are convinced or not convinced, everything you must learn through body language. So body language also one of the important skills which you have to learn. Then self introduction is very important. Knowing about ourselves is very, very important. So we must know about ourselves, our strength, our weakness, our opportunities and threat. So like SWOT analysis, not only for industries or institutions and also for an individual. So our strength, what is our strength, we must know. What is our weakness also, we must know. So the weakness we should overcome by developing the strength. And in self-introduction, we have to tell only about the strength. You should not tell your weakness. They may ask you, tell about yourself means, I am so and so, I have good communication skill, I am a good team player and team leader, I am a leader. In my organization, I was a leader and a club member and all you can tell. But at the same time, you should not tell about your weakness. That will underestimate yourself. And stress management, you have to manage the stress. You may have, you may be tensed and you may get anger. You have to control everything, your stress and your emotions and all. So that is very important. Stress management is very important. And active listening is very important skills. Unless you listen well and you cannot communicate well. So be a good listener and active listener during the interview. And rehearsal is very important. Rehearsal means what? Before going to the interview, you keep your friends and call them. You can make a group in 6 months. You can plan that all 5 members, we should get good jobs in a good company like that. So it is very important you make a group and do rehearsals. So other 4 members can be interview members and you will be the candidate. And you can become an interview member and your friend can become as a participant. And you can ask questions. You can ask them, tell me about yourself and what and all they are lacking and what is their mistake. You can note down. Like that, you attend interview. Your friends can ask about yourself and about the skill or experience. You explain one by one where you are lacking or any mistakes you are doing while communicating, while speaking. They can note down all those mistakes, then they can tell you, and these are the things you have done like that, so that all those mistakes you can overcome in the rehearsal time. So if you do the rehearsals very well, and you can confidently attend the interview. And time management is very important. So time management is, we are not managing the time, you know very well. And we are managing ourselves, our work, we are managing ourselves, we are managing our preparations, we are managing our travel, we are managing. So everything is coming under budgeting, time budgeting, like financial budgeting. Time also we have to make budgeting. So we have to allot the time, and prioritize is very important. Give priority for very important things, which is very, very important. You can make the to-do list of things to do, and give priority, prioritize your work, and you can manage your time properly. So these are the very important interview skills required for an individual. And preparing for an interview again, knowing others is wisdom, knowing yourself is enlightenment. Lao Tzu, a great Chinese philosopher. So knowing about ourselves is very important. So we must know about ourselves. Always we should think about ourselves, and we should improve ourselves. We should be a good human being, and what are the weakness we have, we should overcome from those weakness. And if we need a communication skill, to improve communication skill, we have to improve communication skills in speaking or writing skills, whatever it may be. We may have qualification, we should get experience, additional knowledge we should gain, some computer knowledge, we should learn computer knowledge, and through computer we can learn some application software for presentation skills. So everything is knowing about ourselves and improving ourselves. And can you tell me about yourself? This is very important question will be asked in every interview. So your answer helps employers to know how effectively you present yourself, your own personality. So they will expect how effectively you are presenting yourself. So for rehearsal, if you do this one every interview, they will ask this question. So if you do your rehearsals properly, you know, repeatedly, you will do well and you will present very well. And now coming to curriculum vitae, that is your resume. So when you prepare your resume, let it be a simple one. Simple one which will cover all the information about yourself, your qualification, your experience, your competency in your trade related or your computer related additional qualifications or training programs, additional training program you have undergone. Everything you can give detailedly, but not so many pages. It can be in one page. So well written CV is a mini presentation of good points and achievements. So this one you are sending through soft copy. Most of the companies are inviting applications or CVs or resumes through soft copy. So you can go to the company website and you can share all those or required information through their website. And they have a recruitment menu. If you click and you can fill up the recruitment page, sometimes they may ask you to upload your resume. So you must have a soft copy of your resume. So you have a good resume. According to the nature of work, according to the company, you can tailor your tailoring your CV means what? Tailor means who is a tailor? Tailor is a person who will design your garment as per your requirement. So measurement he will take and draft and stitch the garment like that. You have to tailor your curriculum vitae as per the requirement of the company. That is very important. Which is not required for that particular company, you can remove. Some skills you may have, some additional skills you may have, that you can include. That is called tailoring your CV. And prepare your CV as per the company requirements. Leave no gaps in your CV. Give good reasons for leaving previous employment. So if you have a break one year or 2 years, you have not worked in a company means, you might have worked, apprenticeship you might have done. After apprenticeship, 1 or 2 years, you have not done any work means, you should not tell I was in home, I didn't do any work. You can tell, I have undergone some training program in home. I have learned all these things and I have undergone some training program or I have done some distance education program. So how effectively you have used your, lesser time. You have not wasted your time. That you have to inform. You have to give the valid reason for leaving a company. You might have left some company means you should not tell that that manager is not good fellow, that company is not a good company and all, that will not be a positive information from you. Should give a positive information that for better perspective I have left the organization or that organization itself not functioning well, they have their problems, so they asked us to leave. Like that, any reason, valid reason you have to tell. You should not tell, I don't like the manager, I don't like the company, I left. That and all, gives a negative opinion about yourself. Large companies feed CVs into scanners and do keywords search. So what are the required particular job or nature of work? You may have some keywords. So programming means Java, C++ and all will be there. And computer related means softwares like CorelDRAW, Photoshop, PageMaker and all. So if they find these words, then you choose to for interview. If you do not have for the desktop publishing operator work or desktop publishing related field, in your resume, these terms are not there. CorelDRAW, PageMaker, Photoshop is not there, means your biodata will be rejected because without CorelDRAW, Photoshop, PageMaker, nothing to do with desktop publishing. So it is very important to include the keywords, key terms about the requirement of the post. And preparing for interview, we have already discussed about that. Researching about the company, you are searching about the company, where is it? And you also do research. What is the meaning of research? You are doing research in the internet. You can search about the company and how old is the company, who are the management and what product they are manufacturing and what is their profit and all you can learn. This is called research. You can do research. Every company has website, their own website. So you search in Google, put the company name, type the company name, it will give you complete details about the company, because you are going to attend an interview in the company premises. They will call you for interview, so you must know about the company in detail. For that, you have to do research work about the management and other employers are interviewed by the organization. Sometimes your friend might have attended interview in that organization, or some of your relatives, your brother or elders might have attended interview. So you can ask them what about the company, how they expect, what they will expect and all. So you will develop so many skills through that. For that purpose only, researching about the company is very important. Getting knowledge, gaining knowledge about the company is very important. If you can show that you know the product and company mission, your interviewer get impressed. So if you tell about the company mission, this is your product and this and all you are manufacturing, and this is your process, input process, output. If you tell, then they will be impressed on you. This fellow knows so many details about our company like that. Test before interview. Sometimes before interview, they may conduct test, aptitude test and English language test and numerical ability test. It may be for an hour or half an hour. Some companies will give you objective type of questions to, scrutinize the candidate and to reduce the candidate. If hundreds of people are there for, a few seats, then everybody will not be interviewed. So for that time, they will conduct tests before the interview. So that and all you must know. If they conduct interview test before the interview, then you prepare yourself for the test, written test, objective type of tests, aptitude test or numerical ability test or English language proficiency test and all. You can prepare yourself. Then prepare for self-introduction. Again, we are coming to this. Self-introduction is very important about yourself, your qualification, your experience. Nothing you should forget. Sometimes, people, even experienced people also will tell coming out to their friends, I forgot this thing to tell. They asked me this, I forgot to tell. So if you do rehearsal and all, if you do, repeatedly, if you and practice, then you will not forget all those points. So it is very important to practice and do rehearsals. That is very important. So that your qualification, your experience, your strength and all, and in an appealing and convincing and interesting manner, you can present to the interview board members. And few rehearsals before the mirror or in front of well-wishers. So well-wishers who will not criticize you. Some people will criticize and some people will not be well-wishers. What they will do, you are doing wonderful job. Are you? No problem. You are great like that. They are not well-wishers. Well-wishers always motivate positively. At the same time, they will also pinpoint your weakness so that you can improve all your, needed strength. Few rehearsals before the mirror or in front of well-wishers you can do. And few feel-good factors that I am qualified, have experience, I am well-organized, I am a good team leader, I would fit into this company perfectly. So already we have discussed you are going to an interview and we may see co-participants. So many people will be waiting. So while waiting, sometimes half an hour, 1 hour, 2 hours, we have to wait for our turn. So that time what we'll do, we'll speak to some people. Somebody will introduce themselves and talk to you. That time they may ask your qualification, your experience. If their qualification and experience is more than yourself, then you may feel that, fear. First to fear, you will have the fear first. That fellow have more qualified than me. This fellow is having more experience than me. Then you may get tensed and stress will lead. When you have stress, then you may tend to forget your preparations and all. So avoid all unnecessary talking. Even if you happen to speak to people and share your experience, qualification, don't worry, no problem. You have been selected. You are the one of the most suitable candidates, and so many people might have not been called for an interview. So you have been called means you have confidence that you are qualified and you are well organized and you have good experience. That is why you are having suitable experience. That is why they have called for an interview. So you have that, you have confident that you will be selected. I will be selected. I will face the interview confidently. See, this interview skill and interview techniques and all, you might have seen and you might have heard about so many informations, you might have collected so many information. Very, very important information, very, very important technique or very, very important skill is confident. Have confidence. So confidently, without fear, no fear, confidently you face the interview board members. And whatever knowledge you have, confidently, without any fear, without any confusions, you express, you present yourself. That is very important. You know, whether they are selecting or not, that is different. Very good manner, very complete or satisfying manner, I have completed this interview. That is very important. For that, you should have confidence and do well and prepare well, practice well, do rehearsals very well. No confusions, have confidence, no fear. That is very important. Then set up a practice group for rehearsals. As I told you, you can have your own group. Within 6 months or 1 year, we should be selected for this post. Maybe a government job, you can practice. Or a very good company, IT or electronics company, 1 or 2 months, you set a target with your group, you do rehearsals. Do mock interview with your friends. So mock interviews like models and mock up how we are doing for our training program and all, like that mock interview conduct with your friends. So you will be dressed well, like you are practicing for interview, and the members will ask you questions and you will answer to them. You will convince them by giving proper answers. So that kind of mock interview you practice. And also get feedback for your tone, your voice and body language, eye contact and all. If you are not giving proper eye contact, then they will tell you, they will mark everything. Whatever mistakes you are doing, they will observe and note. Then they will give feedback. So ask feedback after the mock interview. And what is my strength and what is my weakness and what changes could I make and all, you should ask. Get feedback and develop required skill. Very important. And again, listening skill is one of the very important skills of interview. Listening skill is very important. You will be expected to talk for 80% of the time. So 1 hour you are going to be there means, or 30 minutes you are going to be there means, 80% of time you are going to speak. So the remaining 15%, how well you listen is very important. How well you are listening, or how good you are a good listener, that only makes you to present your information, present about yourself for convincing the members. That 85% of your time will be you are going to speak. The remaining 15% will be listening. So that is very important. The listening is very important. So be a good listener. What they are speaking, you listen well, then respond well. Listen carefully to the questions. Say right answer to the question. Establish good rapport with the interviews. So 4 members means you have to see all the 4 members' face, have eye contact with all the 4 members, and respond well and good rapport with everyone. Be a good, with a happy mood, and speak to them properly, have eye contact. That is called establishing good rapport. And God has given 2 ears, 1 mouth. So you must listen more than you speak. Don't speak unnecessarily in the interview, which is not required. That will also will lead to waste of time. At the same time, they will make you a negative opinion about yourself. So don't speak much unnecessarily. Listen much as you can. Listen well, and whatever required, you present well. That is very important. And appearance, manners, facial expressions, posture, gesture, eye contact and all, important elements of body language. So body language skill is very important. How we appear neatly dressed, and manners, how we are sitting, how we speak, how we smile, how we walk, how we open the door, enter to the room. Everything is manners. And postures, it is not only our body language, it is also observing the members' body language. So through observing members' body language, we can also understand something they are communicating to us. That is the importance of learning body language. and gestures, eye contact and all, very important. And see again, what is body language? Is a form of mental and physical ability of human non-verbal communication. So through the postures, manners, they will also communicate to you. So learn all those things. Something they are interesting means you have more chance to be selected in the interview. So observe all those things, learn body language, skills, posture, gesture, facial expressions and all. So posture, gesture, eye movement, facial expressions and all coming in the body language. So again, about body language, 93% of communication is done through body language. Only 7% is words. So that is about body language. Then look good, feel good and sound good factor. We should look good means what? Dress neatly. We should not distract the attention of the members when we go to the interview. So neatly dress, dress well, neatly, appropriately for the industry. Then wear polished shoes. Wear polished shoes. So a shoe should be polished one. It should not be dust or dirty one. And keep a smiley face. Avoid stress and tension. So you may have some tension that you should not express. So stress and all you should not have. So have a smiley face. So these are all looking good factor. And feel good, feel confident and comfortable. So already we have discussed that you are one of the most suitable candidate for the interview. So feel that I have the qualification, I have the experience, I am the most suitable, one of the most suitable candidates. So you attend the interview confidently and be comfortable. Breathe deeply and slowly. This always has a calming effect. Your whole body is relaxed. So if you, even if you are, you need relaxments, just breathe, inhale, exhale properly, well, breathe well, and it gives you relax for a moment. And sound good is speak clearly and confidently. So we have to speak clearly, communicate clearly to the members what and all they are expecting from us. So speak clearly and confidently. That is sound good factor. And seeing eye to eye, keep proper eye contact, contact with the interviewer while speaking and listening. So while speaking also, you have to see, you have to have eye contact, and listening also, you must have eye contact. That is very important. So having eye contact also very important. So practice, again, this is a summarize. We are summarizing, telephone interview will be for summarizing, we'll have the telephone interview skills. Practice with your interview group, again, telephone interview. Also, we can practice with our friends, mirror their verbal patterns and use a low pitches. Achai, this is your qualification? Yes, sir, this is my qualification. So you are repeating that. You are mirroring the verbal pattern means this you have. This is your experience and you have, these are the computer skills you have in your resume. Yes, you repeat it. Don't say only yes like that. You repeat that, yes, these are the computer skills I have like that. You tell where and all programming or application softwares like MS Office or some other Photoshop, PageMaker, if you know, you tell all those. And better stand than sitting. If you attend telephone interview, it is better stand rather than sitting. And say and yes, ask questions regularly because they will not see you how, what kind of person you are. Through your communication skill, the way how you speak only, they will understand about yourself. Say that is why you should say yes, like that. So that shows you are actively listening. That is why this is very important. You are paying attention. Then take notes while you are on the phone. You can recap. So you can summarize that what and all happened, what and all discussed when you have noted down. So for that purpose, this one is very important. And some do's and don'ts. You accurate and appropriate information in CV. That is in your biodata or resume. You have to give proper details. What and all you have, you know, that you should give. In interview, they may ask you whatever you have given in your resume. That time you should not tell, I don't know. Because you have given that, you know that. And in interview, if you tell, I don't know, means that will be a wrong information. So that you should avoid. answer to open-minded questions. Tell me about yourself. You know, open-ended questions always very important question is tell me about yourself. So you practice well and confidently you can speak because you have made so a lot of rehearsal. You have practiced a lot about telling about yourself. So you confidently you speak. Must know the time, location of the interview plan to reach 1 hour before. So you well in advance you reach the interview place so that you will not have tension. Don't make negative comments about previous company and employer. So already we have discussed about this point. So if you left the company, don't tell I don't like this company, that is not good company like that. Give you know some positive comment about that. I want to better opportunity. I want to learn more better than that. So I'm leaving that or some other good points you tell. Keep required original and photocopies of the certificate. So in the preparation stage, we have discussed this before going to the interview preparation and treat interview seriously. No, casually should not attend interviews. Otherwise you will not get good job. It will waste your time. So how confident that seriously you prepare for the interview, attend the interview seriously, you will be selected within few interviews. Interview is two-way interaction. Ask for clarification if needed. So if you have any doubts or clarifications, you can ask. Don't give impression that you are only interested in salary. So don't show that only interested in salary. This much salary I want, this much I'm interested like that. Don't focus only on salary. Don't show frustrations or negative attitude in interview. So you should not be a frustrated person and you should not show negative feelings about yourself. Avoid heavy cologne and perfume. Avoid your perfume, which will give you more stronger smell. And depart gracefully. Again here, if you have done well, feel happy. If you have not done well also, no problem. Depart gracefully. So these are the important points which I have planned for you. Very important thing is before the interview, during the interview, after the interview. So interview maybe with two members, one to one, sometimes one to few, sometimes one to group of people like board of members. So have confidently present yourself, are confident and present yourself confidently and no tension. Whatever you don't know, say don't know and feel good. And before interview, prepare yourself, have all the required documents with you and plan your journey. If it is plan your journey, if it is a distance one, learn about the company, about the organization, nature of work well in advance. Practice yourself, prepare yourself for the interview. You feel at ease, don't get tensed, don't be have tension, no stress, be confident. Because you have been selected for interview, you are the suitable candidate. Have that confident, confidently face the interview. Listen carefully, very important, speak clearly. Use body language, have eye contact, ask questions if required. That is during the interview. And after interview, thank the members, leave gracefully. Check your documents. Don't leave your original documents. That is very important. Think about your strength. Think about your weakness. It will help you in the next chance and hope for the best. So with this, I will complete my session. And believe, focused action beats brilliance any day. As I told you, people may have more qualification than you. People may be experienced than you. If you are focused, if you are focused in your action, preparing well, doing rehearsals very well, it will beat the brilliance. It will beat the over qualification. It will beat the more experienced fellows. So have confidence. Believe focused action beats brilliance any day. So all the best. With this, I conclude the session. I would like to thank Nimi for hosting the session. And I would like to thank the participants for participating in this session. Thank you and all the best.